here to a big night of fights. I'm Joe Tessitore alongside my ringside partner, Teddy Atlas. Looking forward to all the action today, and we're just about set for it. This is a 12-rounder. Here's round number one. A well-timed right hand by Big Train. And now he's targeting upstairs. Wow, is he defensively sound. Good shot there with that left. Big Train's pre-fight talk included a lot of discussion about the need to utilize the jab. Why so?
Well, first of all, he's a good fundamental fighter, and he's not a real physical fighter. So he understands where he has to be good. He knows he doesn't have, you know, great physical skills where he could just knock a house over. He knows he has to be good in this area, using that lead hand, the jab.
Halfway through round number one. Good solid right hand he lands there.
Circle him, move.
And an excellent uppercut by Big Train. Not precise at all by Big Train. Solid hook.
Let's go.
Blocks away that headshot. Oh, and he returns fire with a left hand. What a thudding shot he just landed.
Well, he left the left hand out there a little lazy, and he crashed it over.
And that's the end of round one. Big Train's missing punches. I mean, there's just no way to sugarcoat it. His accuracy isn't there.
And there's a reason for it, Joe. His punches are the wide variety. And wide punches against what? They don't find the mark. They're not accurate.
Here we go. Round two is underway. Staying away from those headshots with his defense up top. Blocks the headshot. That's a fierce left hand that landed by Big Train. He takes a shot and then commits to giving one right back. Big Train showing you a little defensive skill there, able to move away from that punch. Good flush shot by Big Train.
Stay away from the inside.
Teddy, if you could only pick out a few characteristics for a fighter and apply them to them, what would they be?
Well, I think first of all would be the ability to overcome. And the ability to be dependable. Everyone looks at the neon things, the speed, the power, they're tangible. We feel comfortable with those things. We can grab onto those.
Big Train's been stunned. Stunned, but all of a sudden now, surviving. Good left hand able to land. Scored well up top. Not much action as he just ties up. Targeting that belt line with the right hand.
You need to be on the inside.
And you see what he can do when he sends that right to the head. Gets rid of that body shot. Big Train's punches are way off the mark. He's been committed to throwing plenty of them. He just hasn't been committed to hitting plenty of the target.
No, and it's not like his opponent suddenly became the invisible man. I mean, he's right there in front of him. It's just that he's tired, and these punches are coming from left field, and guess what? They're not getting to the plate.
You need to capitalize on his business, okay? A lot of speed, I count him up.
So this round is underway, and what a difference a break makes for him. Look at how fresh he is to start this round after getting hit hard and rocked in that last round.
What a difference a rest makes when the corner knows how to take advantage of that rest. They got water on him, they revived him, they massaged his legs a little bit, gave him some encouragement, good to go.
A well-placed left hand up top. Big Trange really in position to control things in this fight if he can do what he did just there, and that's land a good solid jab.
Jump on him! Nice!
A well-targeted jab that time.
And that's exactly what you need when you want to stay on the outside. Something to keep you away from your opponent.
Big Train's showing us that he's aggressive, but this is not a good kind of aggression. You can be countered this way.
Yeah, it's a reckless aggression. You know, he's just walking in there, you know, with these big wide punches. Something's gonna come in between.
Good counter punch. Not able to land the headshot. Turns over that hook upstairs. That was nice. He just drew the punch from his opponent and then a good counter by Big Train.
Yeah, like running through the rain without getting wet. Beautiful.
A little something for his opponent after getting tagged.
Keep doing what you're doing.
And now he's targeting upstairs. And that's the end of round three.
One more punch to the body. Okay. Yeah, keep boxing. You're doing great. You're making it hard for him to hit you.
So with three rounds complete, we take a look at Teddy's scorecard. Tried to land that upstairs and was off. He is damaged. Oh! He goes down. He has so much time now, he's going to be forced to survive.
One, two, three, four, five. Six.
So now the question becomes, after that knockdown, and he has gotten up, how does he survive?
So one of the ways he survives is if he's been taught. Have good habits, have good fundamentals been put there. You're gonna find out right now. He needs them right now.
To the head he goes with a left hand. I really like what he's doing here. I mean, if you were to pick any one piece of weaponry that you say aligns with what he is strategically as a fighter, it is the jab, and he's firing it off beautifully.
And he's firing it off consistently all night at the right distance. He's getting full extension on that punch, and that's making him effective offensively and safe defensively. He's out of the other fighter's range.
Effective work with that flush overhand right. And you see what he can do when he sends that right to the head.
Hook! Hook!
Keep moving! Keep moving!
Oh, he took some damage, but he gave some back with the right hand.
Double up and punch.
Teddy, you gotta like this because he's using that jab the way you like him to.
Especially when you're being aggressive. You walk in, you wanna walk in where the guy can't see you coming. That jab blinds your opponent.
Good job with another left hand. He had his eyes set on the uppercut, but was unable to land it. Big Train's left landing well. Flush right hand to the head. So he scores a knockdown in the last round. Now he gets to settle down and gather himself. Do you go after it? Do you get super aggressive here having had your man hurt? Or do you still have to employ a certain amount of caution?
It's kind of like being at the carnival. You know, you just you just hit the bullseye and you got that big, big stuffed animal you can give to your wife or your girlfriend. But now he doesn't want you to go away with that.
Oh, no.
No. He tells you, wait a minute, try again. You could trade that in for something even bigger. But you might lose the one you have already. That's the question.
Start of a new round, and I give credit to his corner. Big Train's quarterman did a really good job after a round in which the fighter was knocked down of just being calm and cool.
The way they're supposed to be. You know, we always talk about the fighter having to be calm and the experience that a fighter has. Well, that corner has plenty of experience. They just showed it.
Come on, malfunction.
Good block. Here's something that's a key factor now, and that is his ability to simply defend himself. He's doing a wonderful job at it.
Yeah, he is, and that gives him the ability to always be fresh and confident round after round since he's not taking a lot of punishment.
Good shot to the head with that right hand. Big Train's rock. Look at that. And he goes down again. Will he get up from this? To prepare for a situation like this, but many do. He's been down, now he's got to survive.
So that's where you're wrong. It's not hard to prepare, it's a must to prepare. If you're a trainer, that's what you do in the gym. You teach a guy, if you're in this situation, this is what you do. You grab on, you move your head, you survive.
He just missed that shot up top.
Focus!
He scores with the jab. Oh, and he got caught right there. Everything was going fine, and then he got caught.
Well, that's the problem. It was going too fine. He got a false sense of security.
Great round now. Back and forth after he did the hurting. He's the one. Wow! Well, he's been there before, and now he's there again. He got four.
He can't afford to keep going on that floor. You have to wonder when the referee's going to step in now and stop this.
The question becomes, after that knockdown, and he has gotten up, how does he survive?
So this is where instincts kick in. You got to start moving that head automatically right now. You don't want to stay in the middle.
Listen, that's the kind of round that puts fans on their feet, but the kind of round that gets a corner man anxious. What do you tell a guy after he's been in a back-and-forth brawl like that?
Move your head. Keep your hands up. You know, don't get caught with those shots. We work in the gym to get away from those shots. And one other thing, you guys have a little confidence. You find when you train for a tough fight, you're ready for this.
Listen, I want you to pick his jabs. He throws a jab. Carry it away, and you'll catch it.
As we started the round, I posed this question to you. Is there any hope for him? He's been knocked down numerous times tonight.
Look, there's been great comebacks in this sport. There's always hope. You don't know how deep a man's reserve is inside their soul, inside their mind. But dangerous grounds now to find out.
Teddy, what would you recommend based on what we're seeing here tonight?
Well, two aspirin and then go. Oh, no. Actually, I would say a little counterpunching would be just what the doctor ordered.
That's a better prescription for him. Downstairs with a right hand. Oh, what a hook upstairs. Another big shot comes in. That was a big shot that floored him, and it's a big shot that may end him right here.
That looked like the great pitch of Gray Maddux, his sinker ball. Boy, it went down quick.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine.
Down he goes, but he's going to continue on, beating the count. Big Train's able to avoid that punch. Combination to the head. Boy, some of the old school guys would really appreciate this, wouldn't they, Teddy? Just great upper body movement, so elusive up top.
Yeah, this is an example like they used to say in the old days. He stands right in front of you, and you can't hit him in the backside with a handful of bulk shot.
Big, big shot he just scored with. Can he beat the count? I don't think so here, Teddy.
Now I know where they got that saying, falling like a sack of potatoes.
It's over. Fight is over. Big Train smashed, and he can't get up. Unable to beat the count.
Ladies and gentlemen, by way of knockout, your winner, the Blockbuster.
That's how you end a fight right there. Yes, he was controlling throughout, but he made a good, clean finish with the knockout.
Yeah, as a trainer, you want to know, can a guy punch? Can a guy defend? You know, can a guy control distance? But you want to know, can a guy finish? He got the answer. Yes, he can finish.
For Teddy Atlas, I'm Joe Tessitore. Have yourself a great night.